The game was released in 2016. It was a huge success thanks to its refined gameplay and interesting setting, although there was quite a bit of debate in the community over whether or not it had much lasting appeal as the other entry. Color blindness is a very common condition. According to studies, about 1 in 12 men and 1 in 200 women are colorblind to some extent, and this can obviously be very frustrating. But thankfully, if you like video games, there are more and more games now that actually give options for colorblind players, so they will not be at a disadvantage. So let's take a look at some really good games with colorblind support. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to Chaos Gaming. Drop a like. And at number 10 is World of Warcraft. That's right, the most popular MMORPG of all time. Launching back in 2004, it's been updated and expanded upon countless times. And in 2015, Blizzard finally realized that their game was probably a bit of a nightmare for colorblind players, so they added in some new video settings to help those people out. Now, the colorblind options will make it much more obvious who is friendly and who is hostile, and will also change up the color palette a little bit to make everything easier to follow. Now, depending on what kind of colorblindness you suffer from, it may be a little different. There's never been a better time, if you're colorblind, to get into the World of Warcraft. At number 9, Borderlands 2. Now, this is puzzling, okay? Borderlands 3 does not have colorblind support. It doesn't. There's no setting, despite Randy Pitchford saying there would be one, although I don't think anybody actually takes Randy seriously anymore, so I'm not surprised. But thankfully, Borderlands 2 made sure its players were happy all around when it was updated back in 2014. I mean, really, how embarrassing is that, though? Borderlands 2 got a colorblind mode in 2014, but Borderlands 3 launched in 2019 and doesn't have one, even though they stated it would. So anyway, you can find the colorblind settings in the video menu in Borderlands 2, and that will surely help you get shooting and looting without being confused or left behind. I can't wrap my head around why Borderlands 3 doesn't have this feature. At number 8, Team Fortress 2, still managing to top the Steam charts week after week, month after month, year after year. It is over a decade old, people. Released back in 2007, TF2 is a class-based first-person shooter with a fun cast of characters, each with their own role and personality. You then have to work with your teammates in order to complete objectives and defeat the other team. Now, TF2's art style is one of the most recognizable aspects of it, but if you're a colorblind player, chances are it's not too kind to you at all. Thankfully, there have been quite a few colorblind settings in Team Fortress 2 that you can actually find in the advanced video settings, as well as opening up the console and manually putting in some commands that you can find on various Reddit posts. And good old Valve, making things just a little more less complicated, well, or more complicated than everybody else if you want to look at it from that point. The point is, you do have options if you need colorblind assist if you're going to play Team Fortress 2. At number 7, one of the biggest multiplayer games in history, so it's no surprise that Riot Games have made sure that everyone in their community is accounted for, including the colorblind. League of Legends. Yes. Now, League of Legends is a colorful game with a ton of little details going on every single second. So, if you didn't add colorblind options, you were probably going to be screwing over quite a few players. Thankfully, League does have colorblind settings that can be found in the options menu under the video tab. Now, you'll have to mess around with it a bit because some of these changes are very, very drastic. But at the end of the day, if it helps, then it's good. And it seems that the colorblind mode in League of Legends is good, so I thought it was worth mentioning on this list today. At number 6, Star Wars Battlefront 2. Now, Battlefront 2 got ripped to shreds by everybody. Gamers, critics, moms, dads, cousins, grandmas, everybody when it launched back in 2017. But thankfully, EA got their crap together somewhat, and the game has been greatly improved. Today, Battlefront 2 is a very, very solid Star Wars shooter, and while it's still not quite as good as the original Battlefront from 2005, it's still one of the better Star Wars titles on the market right now. Now, there has been a decent amount of criticism directed toward Battlefront's colorblind mode, but DICE is always making changes. In fact, they've made a lot of changes to the game. So if you haven't played Battlefront 2 in 2017 and you want to give it a go, now you have some colorblind options to choose from. At number 5 today, Overwatch. In such a fast-paced and colorful game like Overwatch, it makes sense that Blizzard put some work into an alternate color scheme for certain players. Now, Overwatch has gone through a lot of changes over the years, some good, some bad, some really bad. But it has still remained one of the most popular shooters in the world, and as you probably know, the game makes use of a large cast of characters, each with their own unique skills and abilities. In order to be really good at this game, you have to know how to use every character to counter everybody else. Keeping up with a game this fast-paced and detail-oriented can be frustrating if you're not fully aware of everything happening around you, your surroundings. So, Blizzard was sure to add a colorblind mode to the game. They continued to tweak it throughout the years to even make it better. Like many multiplayer games, there have been plenty of non-colorblind players who use colorblind settings in Overwatch just to see enemies better. But hey, now you at least know it's there. At number four, Fortnite. Another super detailed, very colorful game by default. So it's pretty necessary that Epic Games added a colorblind setting to help their community out. You'd be surprised how many people suffer from some form or duration of colorblindness. Fortnite is full of bright colors, but it still expects you to be able to identify enemy players out in the distance and keep up with their movements as well. With that being said, Fortnite's colorblind mode has quite a bit of customization in it. Once again, sometimes it's used by players who aren't even colorblind and they just want to change the color scheme of the game so things are easier for their eyes to see. Whatever your reasoning may be, Fortnite's colorblind options are pretty extensive compared to other multiplayer shooters, so that may be helpful to some of you, and hats off to them to make sure and have that feature for everybody. At number three, Battlefield 1. Now, Battlefield games have been hit or miss in terms of which ones actually have colorblind support and good support. Seems like every other Battlefield game will alternate between having colorblind support, and then they won't, and then they will, and then they won't. Battlefield 1 does it the best. The game was released in 2016. It was a huge success thanks to its refined gameplay and interesting setting, although there was quite a bit of debate in the community over whether or not it had much lasting appeal as the other entries. But Battlefield 1 is very detail-oriented as a game, so colorblind options were added to make sure nobody was left behind. Now, they're not quite as extensive as other games on the list, but they're there, and I'd imagine they're still rather helpful. You can find colorblind settings in Battlefield 1 in the Basic Video Settings tab near the bottom. At number two, Rocket League. Now, this is a super addicting game that got a lot of attention for its unique premise and fun. It's got this energetic art style to it. In Rocket League, you take control of a rocket-powered car, which is awesome. You face off in a game of soccer with another team, which is awesome. And you attempt to knock this giant ball into the other team's goal just using the car. It's pretty cool. Super easy to learn, but super difficult to master, which is part of why it blew up as big as it did. But if you played Rocket League at all, you know just how colorful the game is. Tons of bright flashes, particle effects, things I'd imagine can be very frustrating for colorblind players. So, in late 2016, the developers decided to add a colorblind mode to the game, and since then, it's gotten some pretty good reception from all colorblind fans. And at number one today, the entire Call of Duty series. Now, ever since Modern Warfare 3, Call of Duty has always been sure to have a colorblind option, which I commend them on. The earlier versions of colorblind mode were pretty simple. They just changed the name tags and the explosion colors. But over the years, things have gotten a lot more refined and more helpful. Every COD game since Black Ops 2 has had a pretty good colorblind setting mode to make sure nobody gets lost in the fast-paced arcade shooter gameplay. So while you may not want to go back and play games like Ghost or Infinite Warfare, maybe you do, whatever your cup of tea is. Now you know that just about every COD game now has colorblind settings. They're likely not to be going anywhere, so you can give whatever one that interested you back then but you couldn't take advantage of, you can go give it a try. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 awesome games right now that if you're colorblind to any degree, you can go in there and get a quick assist. And I have a friend that is colorblind, and it's got to be frustrating. Super, super frustrating, especially when you're put at a disadvantage when you're playing an online multiplayer game, or even if you're not playing multiplayer. The point is, these have settings that can help you out. If you guys enjoyed this video, if you found it informative at all, drop a like. And on the screen now are two more videos. One of them is red and one is blue, but they have the text there that say red and blue as well. So that's kind of an assist right there in case you do suffer from, and I didn't even think about that. I should have thought about that. Now it makes me look at everything and think about it again from the aspect of somebody actually being colorblind. Click one of those videos, guys. I will see you over there.